One of the state's top races, the race for governor.
It's between Hattiesburg Mayor Johnny DuPree and Lieutenant Governor Phil Bryant. DuPree is hoping for a big Democratic turnout in his push for the governor's seat. We'll have live coverage from DuPree's campaign watch party in Hattiesburg coming up tonight at 10.
And Lieutenant Governor Phil Bryant is being called the front runner in this race.
16 WAPT Scott Simmons is live at the Bryant watch party at the Hilton on County Line Road. It's also the de facto headquarters for the GOP. So Scott, any surprises so far?
No big surprises. Of course, a lot of work going on behind the scenes in some of the upper floors where they've been taking in the poll results, trying to get a feel for at least where the numbers have been coming all the way from the northern part of the state to the southern part of the state. Give you a look at the rumors we have set up here and a lot of national coverage. Fox News setting up here. They're going to be interviewing Governor Barber later. They're going to also be talking about some of the initiatives. But right now, of course, we're talking about the Phil Bryant campaign. Quentin Dickerson with the Bryant campaign staff joining me now. One of the questions as we get to the conclusion of the voting here, we're less than an hour away. Why not more of a combative campaign, and do you think, why did it not happen in this race?
Well, you know, in the primary campaign, the primary election that started back in January, almost 10 months ago, or a little more than 10 months ago, it was a little more combative in the primary, but in the general election, it hasn't been that way. It's been a little more cordial race than folks are used to, and I think people appreciate that. Look, Phil Bryant and Mayor DuPree are friends. They've known each other a long time. They've worked together. And they both of them just didn't see a need for that type of campaign. And I think voters appreciate that. And I think we'll see evidence of that by the turnout today. There's still an hour left to vote, so vote if you haven't.
One of the things that I know you've been doing behind the scenes has been sort of gauging that voter turnout. And you described what is a concern about possible voter apathy.
Well, we have been concerned a little bit about voter apathy, frankly. We've had a lot of initiatives on the ballot that have helped, I think, generate some interest in the overall election. But as you said, sometimes the back and forth drives people's passions a little more in a campaign. And we have had very little in terms of back and forth campaigning. It's been more cordial. So I think overall, that's been a net positive, and I think we're going to see the turnout we'd hope for.
Phil started this morning voting in Brandon and then moved to the southern part of the state, Hattiesburg and the coast.
Right.
Any specific strategic reasons?
Well, we were in North Mississippi yesterday going to Oxford and Boonville and Tupelo. We're in DeSoto County Saturday night with former Arkansas Governor Mike Huckabee, so we thought we need to do some more work on the southern part of the state today and make sure we covered all parts of the state over the last couple of days. So Hattiesburg and the coast, and then came back tonight, and we'll be watching returns here shortly.
All right, expecting Phil Bryant to return to the hotel soon. Thanks
yes,
a lot.
Thanks.
Quentin Dickerson with the Bryant campaign staff again. The room setting up, people coming in to take in the returns. We'll be here to bring them all for you. Live at the Hilton, Scott Simmons, 16 WAPT.